Minister Clarissa Carvalhas.
Father God, I thank you for this day. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for life, health, and strength, Father God. I ask that you cover me, Father God, and bring this word forth like you want it brought forth, Father God. Let them see you and not me, Father God, because it's all about you, Father God. Thank you, and I praise you for this opportunity. Thank you, Lord, for my bishop and pastor, my leaders, Father God. Let the saints receive it, Father God, and use it. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I don't ever try to be long, but I try to get you what I think is good because I can use it, so hopefully you can use it.
Amen.
And my topic is don't give up, and so that's what I'm going to be talking about. And what I'd like to start off with is that God knows, and we know that God has something to do, something for us to do, and whether we do it or not is up to us. So let's turn to Matthew 11:28-30. And that's the first book in the New Testament, so
thank you for the word.
It shouldn't be that. The first book in the New Testament, and 11th chapter. I'm looking for the verse 11, maybe 28, sorry. And I'll be reading 28-30. Okay. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart. And ye shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. And when I broke the scripture down, because the first part of it is saying that you need to come to him because we have burdens and things in our lives that depress us. We get sick and tired of. We get worn out. And all he wants to do is give us peace, to give us that rest in our spirit. Take on his yoke, the discipline of a disciplined lifestyle, of living the word of God, learn of him, come to church and do what you got to do. And because he's a meek and lovely and lowly in heart, he's cool. He's not asking of you too much. I mean, it's nothing compared to what he's already done for us.
Amen.
He, that you'll find peace if you do what he asks you to do in your soul, which is real deep. I mean, that's past. I mean, you find peace in your soul. That's okay. Amen. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. And what I got out of that was, and we do what God wants us to do. It's not like he's going to beat you down and this, that, and the other. It's just a regular, cool, you know, life. He's not asking too much. But what is hard for us is when we try to live the word of God, but we try to do it in front of people, and we try to let them put onto us what they think our lives should be. And it's not really about that. It's about the yoke that God has given us. He doesn't ask us too much. He's not going to have you risking your life and doing stunt doubles and all of that. All he asks is that we live a good, clean, and loving life before people, that we tell people about him, and that we build a better relationship with him. But it's difficult when we have to represent that life in front of other people. That's when it gets hard, because then you're getting stressed out and you're getting worried because you're thinking about what this person's going to say and what that person's going to say. And it burdens our spirit. But God said that he will give us peace in our soul. And the soul is the mind, really, because God said the soul coast is the mind. And we're going to have to be worried. But because we allow people and they're what they think we should do, we get burdened. And I believe this is happening because we don't have a good investment in God. If you invest a lot in him, he will invest in you. Usually we don't want to represent God in front of other people because we don't feel like we're at that place. Say Lecrae or Bishop T.D. Jakes, they got all of that. So they don't need to worry about that minister. They good. They gonna represent God because they got everything they need. But if we invest just the same way in the word of God, we'll have what we need and won't have to worry about, well, I don't have this and I don't have that, and I'm ashamed that people might see this and that about me, because he's going to give you the desires of your heart. He's going to fulfill and give you what you need. All right, so let's move on. Now, I thought of an example. Say you had a boyfriend, and he had you ride around in a clunker car. He didn't look out for you, Whenever you called on him, he wasn't there. I mean, he was busted. His game wasn't good. He didn't have swag. It was nowhere to be found. Would you really want to be found with this dude?
No.
Would you really want him to be around you?
No.
Would you want people to see you with him?
No.
So, why as Christians do we do this to God?
Amen.
I mean, when he need us, we're nowhere to be found.
Yeah.
When he looking for us to pray to him or talk to him, we ain't giving him no time of day.
Yeah.
And then your swag, your Christian lifestyle, usually is not on point. I mean, sometimes people, they just let themselves go. You know, you see those nice looking people, and then a couple of years later, you're like, what happened to you?
Yeah.
That's what we usually do as Christians. You running fast, and you in there. Yes, Lord, I got you, God. I'm going to do this for you, and I'm going to get this done, and I'm going to do it for you, Lord. And I'm going to be preaching the word of God. And then a couple of weeks later, God, like, well, dang, sister girl just let herself go. What didn't happen, boo? I mean, dang. We do that to God. And then you wonder, oh, God, why you ain't blessing me? Why you don't talk to me no more? Why you not helping me out? Because, I mean, dang, you just don't let yourself go like that. Now, at first, the devil, you can't get her. She's too good for you. I mean, she just ain't gonna have that. But now, it's just over. And you can't do that to God. I mean, God is just, I mean, he's not just like us. He's more loving and more compassionate than most of us are. And he's gonna forgive you if you want to be forgiven and truly change your lifestyle.
Yeah.
But if you just letting your lifestyle, I mean, you're not really living the Christian life. You do it in the church. But when you get in front of them people, it's like,
come on now.
I don't think so, God. Not today.
Jesus.
Maybe tomorrow. That's when it really gets hard. I mean, your lifestyle, you have to represent God all the time.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's not too hard. The scripture's not asking us too much. I mean, you just do what the word says to be obedient. I mean, now, the world probably think, well, you being obedient, you let them people tell you what to do, and you doing this, that, and the other. That's when things get hard for us.
Yeah.
But as long as we allow our lifestyle to line up with God, we'll have that peace that nobody can give us.
Yeah.
We'll have joy. You don't have to worry about looking over your shoulder, making sure you're doing this and that for God. If you do it, he's going to give you the desires of your heart.
Yeah.
Now, sacrificial love shown to your neighbors, helping them out, I mean, it's not too much to ask for. And we'll be happier if we just allow God to do what he has to do in our lives. It might be hard sometimes, but he'll get you where you need to go.
That's
now,
right.
I want
right.
to go to Hebrews 4:16.
Thank you for your word.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
Now, there are some people who do come to church and they do what they need to do, and they very few of them, but they do what they need to do, and I think it's because they realize their scripture. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need.
Yeah.
And I think the people that do try to be on point with God, although they do fall, they understand that they can come to God and he'll have mercy on them. And he'll help them when they need to be helped. And then they get back on track and they just try it again. But some people, they just don't, they don't try to get it right. They just keep on going in the wrong direction. Like Pastor Brother Zeke was saying, you're just making it worse for yourself.
Yeah.
You're backing it up when you could be going forward, getting blessings that God has for you. But no, you just... And usually that's be the people, well, this sister, she trying to act like she did. Don't worry about nobody else. You gotta get right. And that's one thing we as Christians need to always remember. Get your crap together.
Yeah.
Or you start talking about somebody else. Because everybody has their rights, the race that they need to run.
Yeah.
If you just worry about what you need to do, don't worry about what else need to do. They trying to get their stuff together. You worry about being yourself. And that's one thing I've had to remember. I'm not going to be up in nobody else's eye trying to get no little twig. No. Get the bark out your front yard. And then you're going to try to help somebody. Help somebody. But don't try to be judgmental and say this, that, and the other. Because you don't know. You don't know. Your time might be right around the corner. Okay. Now, we go back to Matthew. And we look at this scripture. Come unto me, all you who are heavy that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. We don't need to worry about, you know, how I'm going to pay my bills or how I'm going to get this done or, God, you know I got to get this bill paid or, you know, my child need a babysitter. And we just line our lives up with Christ because he's going to be there for you to depend on.
Yes.
But if you don't line your life up with him, he can't help you out the way you need him to.
All right.
And that's one thing I had to realize. If I just gave over what I needed God to do, not getting the attitude, not walking in frustration because I couldn't get it done, if I just lined up my life with him, he was going to supply it. Now, if it came the way I wanted it to come, that's fine. But if it didn't, I was going to rely on him anyway.
Amen.
And that thing that Pastor talked about is walking in confidence. It's usually is a faith walk because you being bold, but you really, really don't know. God, I really need your help, and I really need you to do this and that for me. And you have to walk in that confidence, that faith that he's going to do it.
Yeah.
And most of the time, we allow situations and things to block us.
That's
we don't allow him to just work that work.
Yeah.
And we worry, get confused, get all out sorted. And that's not what God wants us to do. We have that faith. We need to rely on him and do it.
Amen.
And if you do fall down, he's faithful to forgive you and cleanse you of all the things you've done wrong.
Yeah.
And you keep on walking.
Yeah.
But don't stay there. Don't continue in your sin or allow, you know, this, that, and the other to get in your way because you're not going to get where you need to go.
Amen.
Amen.
And so,
Thank you, Lord.
I really looked at this scripture about the yoke and taking on what God has for you because sometimes it's a big responsibility. And you don't feel like, well, God, I might not get this done the way you want me to. Or I'm not really ready because, you know, I still got this or that to deal with. But if you get under your leadership and, you know, submit to them and do what they ask you to do, eventually God's going to bring that anointing to light.
Right.
He's going to show them that you're ready and you can start doing this, that, and the other. But you got to start practicing. You got to start getting in the will and in his way.
Uh-huh.
And that's the part of coming in, helping out, doing this, that, and the other.
Amen.
Helping out the bishop and the pastor realize that they are human too and they want to be appreciated and loved.
Amen.
Not, well, she told me this, that, and the other. I ain't trying to deal with her, this, that, and the other. No.
Come on now.
And we have to run after that Christian wall more than any other carnal thing that we do.
All right.
Because, and you might say, well, Minister, you sound like a hippie. All you talking about is Jesus and Jesus this, that, and the other. Jesus going to pay your bills? Well, he will if you line up with what he wants you to do. Because that's going to want to hinder you and not give you what you need to go forward.
Amen.
And, you know, that's basically what I was going to say to that. And that is that you need to get into that, laying that heavy yoke down, picking up the yoke that God has for you, and walking that good, clean life. And it might be a little bit hard for you. It might be a little tedious, but if you fall down, just call on him to help you get back up and stop doing that. I mean, eventually God will be like, all right, girl, you did that like 300 times now. You need to tighten up. So get yourself together. Might take a couple of times. But do it for real. Not, you know, faking it and quaking it. Do it for real. So that's what I was going to say.
Look at somebody and say, mine. Now look them in their face. She tell you can be serious. She touched a lot of areas and stepped on a lot of toes. Flat footed teacher, and she did it in a way that I like. She did it so that kids could get it, the adults could get it, the young adults, Mars Dean could get it. Everybody got a little something, something, something.
Amen.
It is so true what she said.
Yes, it is.
It's so true, so awesome to hear it from another angle.
Amen.
I love the word.
Amen.
Lining up.
Amen.
Just line up with the word.
Amen.
everything else will fall in place.
Yeah.
And you can't halfway line up with the word.
Amen.
The word said be either hot or cold. You know what Sam Bishop said a while ago? He said, some people are going to die and go to hell right through the church.
Amen.
And I thought about it and said, whoa, that is sad, man.
Yeah.
That is so sad. And our biggest problem is obedience.
Amen.
We were talking about something dealing with, some of y'all know that come to church or whatever, but we're going to have a gym now, and we're going to have another building added to this for the new school year. And God gave it to us. The gym is free. And the building is just, wow. I'm like, what? That's all you want? But anyhow, and Carlisa and Minister and I were talking about it because I have a board now. And it's made up of people who are or have been in business, they're wealthy, tax people, bank managers, people who I could never have drawn to us. And God just sent them to us. And they're wealthy, too. And I say that because wealthy people think different than other people. And I need that mindset. And I was talking to one of them on the phone the other morning, out on the deck, and I was praying, and they called and I answered the phone. And so I was telling a minister what they were saying. And she came out with a statement, blew me away. She said, thank God for wisdom.
Amen.
And I said, oh, that's good, Carlos. She said, you know, most of the time us black people don't want to listen.
Yeah.
We don't want nobody telling us what to do. And God has that the whole board is seven people, they're all white. And I went back to God and I said, why? And he said, because you need to understand that you need to submit to whomever I send.
Amen.
Not just because they black, but because I have sent them. And they're all so good. I mean, it's awesome to go to my bank and the bank manager and us is sitting there talking word. In the middle of the bank, people come around. And she ain't whispering. She like, you know, people need to learn how to serve God and obey God and do the will. And I'm going, this is cool, God. In the middle of a bank, she the bank manager, you know, and she sharing no shyness. What minister was talking about. Being bold out there, sharing no problem talking the word right there in the middle of the bank store.
Amen.
It blows me away. And now she's a part of our board, you know, and she knows the bank industry and whatnot. But it's amazing how strange that is to find someone who will speak the word out loud, bold, ain't got no problem with it on the job, wherever they were, being that light we were singing about yesterday, being that light, being that light.
Amen.
And these people, when they talk to me, they give me learning, they give me wisdom. Now, I can let my mind go there and say, well, they white, and they don't understand black folk, and white people don't understand black folk. But I'll be honest with you, I don't understand y'all half the time either. I really, really don't. So how they supposed to understand us, I don't know. And we've even sat down and talked about George Zimmerman and Trayvon Martin because they said, we don't want this to hurt the relate. They love Bishop and Pastor. And two of them is Mary and Dave, who gave us full usage whenever we want. That still blows my mind. And we can go up there whenever we want to the campground. We know where the keys are and they just use it. Whenever they pay for the maintenance of it, but you use it whenever you want. Those things I don't take for granted.
Amen.
And all of them said, we don't want this to hurt our relationship. We love you and Ellis and Carlisle. They love Carlisle. We are friends and we don't want this. So we talked openly about it. And we can't, everybody agreed he should have got something. One of them said a year. I said, I can't go in a year. But they all agreed he should have paid some kind of way. We came to that agreement. And I said to them, you'll never understand what it's like to be black in America. And they said, we won't. We just don't understand. You know? But to be able to communicate, to build relationship. How did we build relationship? We went to their house. We had lunch. We had dinner. We sat around, laughed, and talked. We built relationship by us being there together and fellowshipping. But there are sons. Thank God there are sons. There are sons of this house. Thank you, brothers. Did you want them? There are sons and daughters of this house that are awesome. I just thank God for the sons and the daughters. Even when you birth a child, that don't make you a parent and that don't make them a son or a daughter.
Amen.
On both sides of the coin, there are responsibilities and accountability. Yeah. On both sides, if you're going to be a son or a daughter, and if you're going to be a mom, see, there's a difference in a mother and a daddy, and a mother and a father.
Amen.
There's a big, big, big difference. Yeah. Same thing with, thank you, same thing with membership. Big difference in a member and a son or a daughter.
Amen.
I tell you, I ask God what happened yesterday and why. Why was yesterday so great? I kept trying to, everything went smooth. I mean,
Amen. We
left the van, William left the van, and the trailer on the grass almost the whole day. Anybody's gone before, I know that they come down, and here come the sheriff department, you got to move that van. You know, everything went. And I'm like, what is going, why? Because I want to bottle it.
Yes.
What's the difference? You know, I want the formula. 1 + 1 - 2 / 4. What's the formula? And God spoke to me this morning. He said it was the fellowship.
Amen.
He said the people that were there were your sons and your daughters.
Amen.
And everyone was in oneness.
Amen.
And because everybody was in oneness, God could just move so easily through the day. Some people went home wet, but they were smiling.
Amen.
You know, it wasn't no evil, wrong. People who God wanted there were there.
Amen.
Because sometimes Bishop said, well, why are people so hard-headed? Well, we know all year when Yorktown is, why would they do other things on today? Because they're members.
Amen.
And I know people don't like that, but it's the truth.
Amen.
Because if you want to do something, you'll take off.
Amen.
Especially black folk.
Yeah.
I can't make it to work today. When you wanted to be with that man or that woman, or you wanted to go to the club, wherever you wanted to go, we found a way to do it.
Amen.
But when it comes to the things of God, as ministers said, we keep trying to do it our way.
Yes.
That was a day of obedience. That was a day, we do that once a year.
Yes.
And that was a day to support those that got baptized. You remember how scary it was.
Yes.
The water's moving. And then she keeps going further and further out. I even said, because I was cold, I said, how far are you going to go? And he said, he just kept pulling my hand, saying, come on. I'm like, okay, listen, because you know the water gets right about here, you're like, then he comes talking about, just dip down in the water and get soaked. I'm going, okay, the blood of Jesus. You know, and you're supposed to be there to support those people.
Amen.
They're nervous.
Amen.
Is Bishop going to drop me? Is Pastor going to drop me? Am I going to come back up? Lord, forgive me of all my sins so I don't drown out here. And Carnice has put the word out about jellyfish, so nobody wants to swim anymore. And oh God, they jump. But I heard the jellyfish don't bite during baptism.